Hey you guys, what's up glam girl squad? Welcome back to the channel, y'all. It's your girl Andelle. So y'all, in today's video I will be doing a hair install and also curling this beautiful bomb hair. To first start off, we are going to grab a wig cap, and I'm going to be using this wig cap that I got from the hair store. And y'all know, when you go to the hair store, at least the one that I go to, it's pretty hard to find these hair caps, so definitely make sure that you stock up. They're normally like 99 cents, so I normally grab about 5 of them every time I go, no matter what I'm getting from the hair store. I always keep a stock at home, so literally you will see a drawer filled of stocking caps because you never know when you're gonna need them. So I used the Got2b hairspray to just spray down my edges, and I'm just gonna use the Got2b free spray, which is this yellow bottle. Y'all know all about that. Do not use Gorilla Glue. I repeat, do not use Gorilla Glue. And we're just gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna start spraying down the cap just so it can just lay on my skin, and then it can give like a real like skin like finish underneath the wig, especially a colored wig. For my colored hair, I always use a stocking cap underneath just because I find that it really works really well with giving a nice scalp look underneath the wig, because my hair is dark, as you guys can see. My natural hair, my beautiful hair, my popping hair is really dark, so the stocking cap gives an illusion, darling, an illusion of a really bomb scalp all the way through. So I'm just blow drying the ends, just making sure the ends are stuck, because we're going to be cutting this part off. Y'all see I got this stocking cap all up on my eyes, and this is really the best way to kind of get it to really be super flat and just not like lift up. So try this method out. I'm blow drying it on cool because there's no need to blow dry it on hot. At least I don't find a need for it. And then I'm just using my rat tail comb that I got from the hair store as well. And this is my favorite comb. It's a carbon fiber comb, which literally means that it could just take some heat. Take a little bit more heat than the regular rat tail combs do. And I just love the fact that when my scalp gets itchy with these wigs, I lift up my wig and I'll just scratch my scalp. Like, it's the best method to scratch the scalp. Trust me. Even when I do oil my scalp, girl, it still be a little, you know, needing to get scratched. So I'll use my rat tail comb to do that. And I'm just blow drying that all the way through, just making sure that it is fully dry, because we need it to be real secured, especially for this install. And next I'm gonna take some makeup on a regular just makeup brush, and I put the powder makeup on to the scalp, to the stocking cap, just so it could really blend really bomb into my hairline. And I do this, I just saw this trick, I saw a lot of hairstylists doing it, and I'm like, let me try it too. And I really like it because it just gives the stocking cap a real true tone to my skin color, because this is the medium color stocking cap, but it doesn't really match my skin tone all the way. So I just like to apply some makeup that is pretty close to my skin tone pretty generously onto the cap, so that it could just match me a little bit better, especially like when I contour and all that good stuff. I really wanted to just match my skin. So that's what we just did right there. It's super easy. Make sure it's powder though, because when you use a liquid, it does get a little bit icky. So now I'm just grabbing my scissors. I'm just gonna cut along the stocking cap. I try to get it pretty close to the hairline, not directly on the hairline, but just like a little bit above the hairline. And I just start just cutting off that stocking cap, just so I can just make sure that it's literally just enough. You don't need the stocking cap to go all the way to your eyebrows. You just want to get it right above your hairline. And this is pretty self-explanatory. Just make sure to not cut yourself. I'm pulling the stocking cap up, and then I'm cutting with my scissors. And I got these scissors a long time ago. I do need some new shears. I need something a little bit sharper. Before I was just playing around like, oh yeah, I'm not gonna really be doing hair like that. But I found that I really do love doing my hair. It's pretty fun to me. I just love it. I love, I was gonna lie, I don't really love making wigs. I like to have the wig already done. But outside of that, I do love styling. I love coming up with creative ideas to do. And for now, I really enjoy doing it myself. But I do probably want to get somebody to do my hair more often, because this is cool and all that, but ain't nothing like sitting in the chair and having somebody else do your hair for you. So I'm just going and just cutting off all that extra cap that we don't need, just getting it really close to my hairline. I'm a perfectionist, so I just really try to get it just the areas that I really need it. And then if there is anything left over, I just, you know, cut off the rest, snip, snip, and just get it real close. Pretty simple. This is all beginner friendly right here. If I could do this, you could do this too. People always say that. You're like, girl, I can't do that. You can't do it. You can't, trust me. This is the first time I did this. I left the ends of it just hanging off. Normally I cut it off, but I found that, you know, girl, that's what I did. I grabbed both ends and I just tied them in the back of my head. And I find that typically this stays on longer. It's out the way. And I kind of tied it, you know, it looks kind of like a do-rag. And then I just cut off the extra part that I don't need. And then that bad boy is on. I don't have to sew anything or do anything like that. So yay, I got a baldy. Imagine if I was bald, y'all. Not my look. So now I'm going to take my red hair, which I'm obsessed with. This is Snob Life 26-inch lace wig. It is not a HD lace wig. It's just a transparent lace, which is really bomb. I really love Snob Life's hair. Super bomb. I've never had any issues with them. No shedding, no tangling. Of course, you know, you guys got to comb out some of the hair at the bottom. And I'm just over here getting digging. I don't know. Guess what song I'm dancing to? Like, girl, what? Okay, get it, Andy. Go. Hey. Y'all, so yeah, the wig looks crazy right now, but this is the art of styling. I'm just checking out what the parting looking like. I'm just measuring it to just see where I'm going to actually spray it down. I added about 2 bundles to this wig just because, like, my hair is super, super full. But I think you could fit about maybe 3 or 4 bundles in this thing. To actually put the wig down, I am going to be using the Gots to Be. This is a, what is this? This is the hairspray. So it's not the free spray. I like this. I had seen LaRaysia Andrea. Hey, girl. I had seen her using this in her videos. And I was like, let me try it. And it really melted her lace really well. And I find that this melts the lace well, too. It doesn't give a real crunch effect like Gots to Be does, the free spray. But it is in the Gots to Be family. And I got this off Amazon for, I think, like $5. So check out my Amazon store. It is an affiliate link. It'll be linked in the description box in the bio. And that just means that I make a little bit of coin, literally, off of every purchase. So if you are going to be getting off Amazon, definitely get it off my store. And if you don't want to get off my store, cool. Just go to Amazon.com and then just type in Gots to Be. So now I'm just pressing in that lace. I have it on cool first. And then we're going to go into hot. No, actually, right now I have it on warm. Warm first and then cool it down. And I just saw Slade by Jordan doing this method. He has a really bomb YouTube channel that he has a lot of hair content. So he kind of inspired me to get back into making some hair videos because you watch his channel. Well, I watch his channel and I just feel like I could just do all the hairstyles that he got going on. He make it look so easy, but it's definitely hard. I gotta work on my tweezing and doing my baby hairs, but Mingy put me onto this really good baby hair brush, so I'm definitely gonna try that out, and y'all see it in this video. I'm just blow drying that. Oh yeah, here's baby hair brush. It's called Baby Tresses. It's an online store, and this is what the packaging looks like. I use it so far and I really like it. Before I used to be like, oh, you don't need no edge brush, but girl, you definitely need an edge brush. I used to use a toothbrush and it's not the same. The edge brushes are just more dense. And they just like really are made for baby hair. So I just use what it's made for and I do what I gotta do with it. So I'm just spraying and just kind of just getting that lace onto my head. I did cut a little bit of this lace off, so I am having to pull it, which is a no-no with lace. You want it to just sit exactly where you place it and no tugging. So yeah, I'm still learning. I'm not a hairstylist. I'm not even licensed. But I just have beauty in my genes, so I think I could do everything when it comes to beauty. And my hair comes out okay. It comes out good enough for me. So that's why I'm just sharing that with you guys. But I'm not a professional, so yeah, I do make mistakes. And so I'm just making sure that part is secured and holding it down with my finger. I do like to put my wigs on and create my wigs without any nails because it's just easier. But if I gotta wear nails and do my hair, then I still do what I gotta do with it, so... Yeah, y'all, and I'm spraying it with Gots to Be, not Gorilla Glue. Did y'all see the Gorilla Glue Girl? Did y'all see Gorilla Glue Girl? You had to see her by now. If you didn't, you live underneath a rock. So basically, Gorilla Glue Girl, which is like crazy that they even call her a girl because she's a full grown woman. She's like in her 40s. But long story short, she used Gorilla Glue, not Gorilla Snot. She's Gorilla Glue to just lay down her hair. And I'm like, what? I would never, because I'm such a punk. Like, I'm so scared when it comes to things like that. I will read the instructions 10 times over before I even do anything like that. But people make mistakes. So she sprayed her hair with Gorilla Glue, and her hair was stuck like that for a month. And I was so interested in the story because I kept checking back, like, what are the updates? Like, what's going on? She tried to use acetone. Then a fake Gorilla Glue account chimed in. And I'm just like, what in 2021 is going on? Y'all know 2020 was crazy, but 2021 is starting off a little crazy too. Like, is this just, we just gonna get crazier years after that? So this wig is on and it's not secured with Gorilla Glue. It's secure with that's to be. It will come up with a little bit of water, a little bit of sweat. It will come up. It will come up. Trust me. So I'm going with my Nairobi, and this is what I used to kind of lay down my baby hairs with. I love it. It's a foaming wrap. I believe I also have that on my Amazon store. A lot of things that I use in this video are from Amazon or from an online store, so y'all could definitely get that. So I'm just kind of just creating some baby hairs. I had cut some baby hairs already because this is my reinstall of this wig. This isn't the original install, which I love about Snob Life Hair, is that you can reuse the wig, and you know, you can move it around. You could do up, down, you know, side part, middle part. It's free parts. You could use a, you could do a part any which way you want. You could braid it if you want. It is a full lace wig. Because I add bundles, I can't part it in certain ways, but you could definitely, you know, part it down the middle, part it down the side. You could do a zigzag part if you want. It's just so versatile, and the lace lasts a really long time as long as you're not just like scratching at the lace or being extra rough. So definitely be soft when you're cleaning your lace. And if y'all want to see a video on me cleaning my lace, definitely let me know. I got you. But so yeah, back to Gorilla Glue girl. She started using acetone. Gorilla Glue told her to try that. They also reached out to her, but they never said what they actually said to her. But outside of the fake account coming through, they said, you know, try some acetone, which she did. And that video was painful to see. She was like literally bawling her eyes out because it was so painful. And I can't even imagine, because acetone is strong as hell. Like, I use it to take off my nails, and I put it in a plastic cup one time and it literally burned through the plastic cup, which was a no-no because I didn't know that you can't put it in a plastic cup. But that thing started leaking. I'm like, oh my God, oh my God. I started running, and before you know it, the whole cup was like literally had a hole down the bottom. So I can't even imagine putting that on my scalp. But she ended up having to go have surgery to have it removed. So thankfully, our good sis still has her hair back. And she learned from her mistake. And I'm sure she'll never do that again. Because, yeah, she can't do that again. But she did start a GoFundMe. And she did donate proceeds of that to... she donated proceeds of her earnings to a charity. I can't remember exactly what it was. But it had to do with surgery for that type of issue. So... kudos to her. She only asked for $1,500 and she got $20,000, over $20,000. So that's really lit. I'm happy that she's able to get her hair back, because girl, I don't know what I would do. Girl, I don't know what I would do. Now I'm just combing out my hair and I'm just securing the baby hair down with this elastic band. This is an OG elastic band. I had got it from Michaels. It's a elastic band that's a yard. They sell it at Michaels. It's pretty inexpensive. I think it's like $5 and you get a really long piece of it too. So I just cut the part that I need. I should probably just go to Michaels now and just go get an extra one, because this is the only one I have. And when I don't have this, I am like real, I'm like, oh my God, where's my elastic band? Where's my elastic band? Because this really like just holds down the lace for the time being, and you could just style your hair while it's just melting down. So you got to get one of these if you are going to be installing your own lace, boo. You have to. You have to. So y'all see how that part looks? Like, it looks like an actual part. That's not my scalp. That's the stocking cap underneath. If I didn't have that part right there, also I tweezed it, but if I didn't have that part right there, you would just see my black hair, and I don't like that look. Now I'm going to go with my Karakare. This is a wax stick. I'm just going to apply that right at the root of the hair. I don't apply it all the way through because it is a wax and I just don't like how it makes my hair feel like heavy. I like the hair to be flowy. And when you're wearing wigs and stuff, you don't need to apply too much products. After you style it, you just need to just, you know, curl it, whatever you got to do. But don't apply too much product to the actual hair, especially if it's like a heavy product like a wax. Just try to keep it exactly at the root. Now I'm going to go and grab my new favorite hot comb. This is EAP Heat's hot comb, and I put it on 430, and look at how flat that got my hair. Like, what? Like, hold on. Let me show you guys again. Look at that. That looks so flat. What? I'm obsessed because before this, I had this hot comb girl. I had got it from Sally's, and I got a lot of things from Sally's, and this is no shade to Sally's. I'm just telling y'all what I got, where I got it from. But it, I thought it was going to be it, but it took like, you had to actually, the old hot comb I had, you had to get it started before you did everything. So I would like do my makeup, everything. And then by the time I got to my hair, it would be warm enough. And sometimes it wouldn't even be hot enough. It went to 500 and I never seen it at 500. I have to leave it on forever for it to get hot. And I love the fact that the EAP heat hot comb, you just actually turn it on and it gets super hot really fast. And also it has an auto off button. So when you're done, like I don't ever remember to turn it off when I'm done, but it automatically turns off. So I don't have to worry about, you know, it still being on, me accidentally grabbing it or doing anything like that, which is a plus. Also, it gets really, really hot and it just gets your hair super flat. Like I'm obsessed with this hot comb. It's my new favorite one. I had to throw my old one away because it's like, why would I even go back to it? I haven't thrown it away yet, but it's going in the trash because I hate it. Like, what's the point? So I found a new boo, and EAP Heat is an online brand. It is black owned as well. So you guys could definitely check them out. They really have really good hot tools, especially if you're looking for something that, you know, will get your hair real slayed. If you're doing it at home, just trying to get that salon look at home. So right now I'm just parting the top of my hair just to get it real flat. Because that's just my look right now. I want my hair to be flat, flat. Like I want my hair to be giving Arrogant Tay. I want my hair to be giving Hair by Him, Paul. I want my hair to be giving flat. I don't want it to be giving thick, you know, cone head. Like cone head is just not the look. So now it's the next day, y'all. I'm not gonna lie, I changed my outfit after I saw the hair. I was like, "Oof, it was a lot of work." So it's the next day. I just I did take off that band, but I put it back. And now I'm just gonna curl my hair. I went back to Sally's, and let me tell you guys about my experience at Sally's. So I went to Sally's, and I just was walking in, and she's like, "Oh, what are you looking for?" I'm like, "I'm looking for a curling iron." She's like, "Yeah, our inexpensive ones are on the bottom shelf." And I'm like, first of all, who told you I'm looking for an inexpensive curling iron? Like, I'm looking for the best curling iron I can get. I don't really want anything inexpensive. And just don't assume that's what I want. And I'm like, when I worked in retail, I never assumed anybody wanted an inexpensive item. I'm like, these are the hot curling irons. Like, what are you looking for it to do? Then we can go from there. And I could just tell you as far as performance wise, you know, and then if somebody says I'm looking for something inexpensive, I'll say, okay, cool, here's what we got. But the fact that she asked me if I want an inexpensive one first was just threw me off. And then she also was offering me the same brand of the old curling iron that I had that broke. And I was like, oh, no, boo, I'm ready to invest. So I regret that at the time I didn't just buy the curling iron I have now. This curling iron is from Babyliss Pro. And if you guys don't know, on my channel before, I did use Babyliss. There are straighteners, and the straighteners are like blue. So if you guys are into hair, you guys might have seen it before. But their straighteners are blue and they work really, really, really well. So I really felt confident in getting the curling iron because I already know the company was really bomb. EAP Heat does not have any curling irons at the moment. Otherwise, I would have gotten the curling iron from them because I know their hot combs are really good too. So I will be using their hot combs too in another video, but I didn't use it today because we're curling our hair. So yeah, the curling iron that I had bought before was like $35 and the Babyliss curling iron was like $50. And I was like, especially if I'm gonna be curling my hair more often, I love when my hair is curled because you can wear your hair curled for a couple days, but when you straighten your hair, you always have to like re-straighten it the next day. It doesn't ever stay as bone straight as when you first straightened it, if that makes sense. So curls are just easier. You can always just, you know, put your hair in like a little bun at the end of the night and then you can wake up and you still have some curls left. You might have to touch up a few pieces, but curls just last a little bit longer. So I'm spraying my hair down with the Sebastian's hairspray. I like this hairspray because it doesn't keep your hair so stiff. You can still move the hair, you can comb it out and it's still flexible, but it also holds a curl. Like, that's the best of both worlds. It has a nice soft scent to it, so it's not too like, you know, smelling all like stinky, but it's really, really good. I would recommend it. I believe I have that on my Amazon store as well because I got that from Amazon. I got the Cara Care from Amazon. I got the Nairobi from Amazon. Like, literally everything was from Amazon. So this half of my hair is curled and it was pretty repetitive, just wrapping around the barrel, as you guys saw. And I'm not going to kill you guys and bore you guys with another round of me curling my hair again. So this is what it's looking like right now. I'm just adding in a few more layers to my hair because your curls are nothing without layers, nothing. So I'm just adding some layers in. Girl, I don't know how to do layers. Like, I didn't go to beauty school, like I told y'all before. I'm just doing what I think is right. So I'm just trying to cut some layers in and just give it a little bit more body. And it looks pretty. I'm just curling some parts that might have fallen. Yeah, curling that girl up. This red hair is super bomb. I'm thinking about what next style I should do with my hair because this is really bomb. Like, I love it so much. It's my favorite hair color, to be honest. I used to be so opposed to it, but I'm like, it's bomb. Like, it's about to be my signature look. Red hair, it's giving very much Keisha Cole. You know, did y'all see that battle with Ashanti? Who we all rooting for? I went with Ashanti because I love me some Ashanti, and her song just got me more hype. But I do love me some Keisha Cole too, so yeah. That's another topic for another day. But you guys, if you guys want to see my eyeshadow look, I will be doing a eyeshadow look with this exact look in a video for you guys, so you guys will definitely have that on your radar because it's coming right up for you guys. And it's super easy, and look at this hair. I love it. It's pretty. This whole install was done by me, curled, dyed, all that good stuff. I love the body, I love the bounce. It's not giving stiff, and it's just super frizzy. Pretty. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I will check you guys in my next video. Have a really bomb day. Do not use Gorilla Glue on your hair, boo. Use the Gots to Be for a glueless install. I love y'all. I'll talk to y'all later. We'll hang out again soon. Bye, boo. Make sure to subscribe to the Glam Girl Squad. Hit that thumbs up button notification. And comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on this video. I love y'all. Bye.